Hey guys, Janik here for Cinecom.net and welcome back to another awesome, entertaining and mind-expanding Copycat Friday. And today we are having a look at another trending music video from the upcoming rapper Lil Uzi Vert. The video is called Futsal Shuffle 2020. And I think he wants to introduce a new viral dance, like Fortnite or so. I'm not sure. I'm not really a dancer. However, Jill is. That's enough, Jill. It's okay. It's okay. But beside the dancing, the video is also full with effects. And if we want, I think we can do like 5 copycats about the video. But sadly, it's not possible. We can't do that. So we picked out the effect we liked the most, which is of course a time glitching chromatic aberration effect. And maybe, just maybe, we have a surprise effect on the end of the video. So stick around to find out. Now, let's start with the effect. Hit montage.
We're going to the next location.
And we've made it to the next location. Are you ready, Jill?
I'm ready as ever.
He's looking gorgeous, like hell.
Thank
you. Oh man, this vlog camera is way too heavy. Guys, don't vlog on a red.
So I thought Jill was a dancer. Is he?
I am.
And now back to the studio!
And that's it for the lighting in the third location, which is now inside in the studio. If you shoot in different locations, you can make beautiful transitions between them and have a more dynamic music video. Now, right now we are kind of recreating the neon light feeling that you also see in the music video itself. And that is simply done with just some blue light on the top and a red light from the side. I'm also just going to mix in a little bit of daylight so that we do get some more like natural skin tones and other colors coming through. Super easy, easy peasy.
You know what's also easy peasy? Creating a website with Squarespace. Let me show you. With Squarespace, you can create a stunning website with just a few clicks. Choose out of multiple gorgeous templates and kickstart your website. For every style, they have a template. So much that choosing is the hardest part of creating a website. Then with the drag and drop principle, you can easily adjust and add parts to your website. Need a photo gallery? Done. Maybe a map to your dance studio? Click, drag and place. Heck, you can even adjust your menus with some simple clicks. And that's not all. Oh no, if somehow you get stuck and need some help, Squarespace is there for you. With their award-winning support, they will guide you to the wanted result and the perfect website. And speaking of guides, they also have a super detailed analytics backend, which you can use to guide your website to being even better. As you can see, Squarespace knows what they are doing. So go to squarespace.com and use our coupon Cinecom at the checkout for a 10% discount. Or you can click on the first link in the description below to make it yourself easy. Now for the footage, you don't really need to do something special. Just let your actor dance. However, try to let them do some bigger movements when dancing. This is because the effect will work best if you have bigger movements. Then the time glitch can be fully appreciated. Now that the preparations are done, let's begin with the post-production. And guys, we are creating it in the beloved Premiere Pro. So open that up and let's start by dragging the footage of our actor dancing to the timeline. We are mostly going to work with frame holds and cutting pieces out of certain movements. During small movements, you can let the talent freeze for a brief moment. But when the movements of the dancer become larger, then you want to make bigger jumps in your edit. Of course, these cuts and frame holds will be different for everyone, because we all have different footage and dance moves. But the principle remains the same. Here Jill is making small movements. Let's go 4 frames forward, then create a cut on the clip, and now we are going to add a frame hold behind that cut. But first, duplicate the clip behind the cut. Now select the original one, right click on it and choose add frame hold. Then take the duplicate and place it a few frames behind the first cut on the same track as the original clip. This will give you a small part of motion, a few frame holds, and then the motion continues where it ended before. Now you can repeat this technique as much as you want on smaller dance movements. You can really mix it up. Once this is finished, you created a more choppy playback. Already a great start for the effect. Now let's jump to the bigger movements, where we are going to create jump cuts. Get it? So just before Jill starts to swing with his arm, let's make a cut in the beginning motion. Now go further in time and look for a point where Jill's arm already moved a bunch further. Here you can make a second cut and also drag everything behind that cut to the left against the previous cut. Then again go a few frames further in time and make a cut. Next we need to frame hold the short clip we just made. So place your playhead on the previous cut and right click on the clip you want to add a frame hold. Look for add frame hold and of course click on it. Okay guys, drinking game. Every time I say cut, you drink. However, don't kill yourself, please. Then we are going to add another time jump. So again go further in time and look for another point where Jill's arm moves a bunch further. Make a cut and again drag the clip to the left. This time you can let the clip play for a few frames and then make the next cut. Now you can repeat the same principle over and over again. Just make sure that when your dancer makes small movements, make the playback choppy and not jumpy. And when the dancer starts to do bigger movements, then it's time to jump around. When you are done with that, you will have a sequence like this. Already looks cool. However, it's still missing two very important effects. And that's the extra motion blur and of course the chromatic aberration. First, let's start with the extra motion blur. Now because Premiere Pro doesn't have the forced motion blur like After Effects does, we have to be creative and use some masks. However, we first want to select every clip and duplicate it to the track above. Then select the duplicates, right click on them and choose Nest. This will combine everything in one layer and will be easier to work on. Now for the extra motion blur, this will only be needed on the jumpy movements. So look for that point in your timeline and here you can create a mask around the body part that is moving fast. In our case, this is the arm. Also feather the mask a bunch. Now animate the mask so that it follows the fast moving arm. However, when the slow movements of the actor start again, we don't need that extra motion blur. So now you place the mask outside of the frame and animate it back in when the second fast moving part starts. The next step is adding the directional blur to the nested sequence. You can already crank up the blur length to around 20. Now for the direction, you need to look at the position of the arm and how it's going to move. You probably also need to animate the direction of the blur so that it follows along perfectly with the arm. Of course, repeat this for every jumpy sequence you have. That was it for the extra motion blur. Now let's create the chromatic aberration. First, create an adjustment layer and place that on top of everything. In the effects library, search for the VR digital glitch and drag that to your adjustment layer. This effect will also distort your shot, not something we want. So open up the distortion property within the effect and you can set the distortion rate to 0. This will remove the glitch cubes. Now to reintroduce the chromatic aberration, you just need to animate the color evolution. On 90, the chromatic aberration will be gone. This will be our starting point, and while going further in time, you can decrease and increase the color evolution. Play around with the chromatic aberrations on the part where the dancer moves fast and slow. Let yourself go and mix it up. And that was it for today, guys. And you know what that means? Janik's Fun Fact Fountain! This fun fact is going to be a little bit different. To be more precise, it's going to be an extra effect. Do you know the transition effect from the Atlanta trailer? Well, you should, because we did a copycat about it. However, Lil Uzi Vert did saw the trailer and got inspired by this, and even created something similar in his music video. He went for a handheld variation. And let me explain how he did it. Just film your subject and after a while move your camera in an arch towards the ground and over the ground eventually. And then for the next shot, you can start with moving over the ground and up to your dancer. You can repeat this as much as you want and keep creating seamless transitions. In post-production, you just need to stitch up the two clips on the moment you move over the ground and in the motion blur. This will cover up the cut and make it seem seamless. easy peasy. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you learned something new. Thank you, Squarespace, for the support. And like always, stay creative. I have a little quiz for you. How many times did I say cut this episode? Is it A, 18 times? Is it B, 20 times? Or is it C, a trizillion gazillion times? Let us know in the comments below and the winner will get Jill. You pay the postage.
Ooh, baby, I love you.